Steve Fuller, game name, with a quick video on the new Shadow Ops. I believe this is the best way to do it for the new setup. It just came out, I believe, December 1st, and so I played around with it a little bit, and thought I'd show you a pretty clean way to do it with very little damage. At the end of the video, I have zero damage because I sent some things back to the base to be healed while I was continuing to attack the base, so essentially no damage. The railgun is out of range if you've got your max level range on your Jericho. You can also use, at the beginning I was using my technicals, and they work as well. Right here, what I'm doing is I'm clearing those two bunkers so that I can bring some air in and clear the billy goat type Vercraft units in the corner. So I wanted to take these bunkers out as well, because they do like to shoot at me. Now, if I had waited for those other guys to go back, I probably wouldn't have been hit there. Very minor damage, but I'm going back to my base anyway, because my Jericho had taken a few seconds worth of damage, and I wanted to bring him back fully repaired. So now, I'm going to use 7 Furies. I've done it with 4 Furies. You can do it with 4 Furies. You don't really need 7. It's actually a good idea probably to use 4 in case you do take any damage. You'll take less damage. And they do, surprisingly, about the same amount of damage. 4 Furies do about the same amount of damage. And you'll notice here that they're shooting my drones, but they're not really shooting me. You see my Furies have no damage. You have to learn where exactly to come in, and the danger side, actually, is the first side that I did. This side, you want to make sure that you're turning away from the hunter, otherwise you will get targeted by the hunter. Make sure you turn away from the hunter, as I did. In other words, towards the outside of the base. There is a bunch of anti-air guys out there, so don't go too far out. You'll see that there's some anti-air guys there. So what I'm doing here is I'm using my Liberator Hero to take the damage because he has a shield, while I take out the railgun and the Overwatch. And here, be careful that rocket silo in the back will shoot uniques, so you have to be careful. I'm trying to draw this tank out so that I can stun him or shock him with my charged ordnance that I have on my buggy. And additionally, if you can damage him, it's better. I am trying to draw him out a little bit because there is a one of those billy goat things that really shoots missiles very far. And the Vercraft billy goats that shoot the missiles, their missiles do a great deal of damage. They're not like a regular nightmare. They are, they're something else. So this is about the area where I haven't quite figured out a way to get around this. I think if I use, I can't think of his name right now, but my Liberator Hero, I think if I use him here, because I use him on the other side and he works great. Audra, as tough as Audra is, and all the special heroic things I have on Audra, She seems to take too much damage here, and if I can figure out a way, I just didn't want to use my hero twice, because then I would have to send him back to the base again. So we'll set Audra up, healing a little bit. Everything else is free repair, and she's got a little bit of damage. Jericho wasn't quite there yet again, so with the Jericho I'm going to kill this Vercraft type Valiant that's back here, and sometimes I can damage the buggy there, and sometimes he'll come out, but in this case he didn't come out and I didn't quite get any damage on him. Send Weaver, that's his name, Weaver. Send Weaver in here. Weaver doesn't really take that much damage. I'm shooting for the middle because I only want to shoot this side one time. Now there's really not much left here. I don't really even have to take this out. I just wanted to clear this side. Sometimes I like to take the antenna out because you can bring Dina in, and I was saving that power plant because I was thinking about giving this base away, but the person that I was going to give it away to apparently didn't show up, so I just decided to keep it. Clearly, I could have cleared this with my Jericho right now. I got a little distraction going on in here with the zombies. It's something I really like on all my heroes. I got the zombie on all of them, and it's a cool little feature. Not only does it distract, but it also zombies will kill some of the buildings adjacent to the buildings that you kill, so that's an extra added bonus. You don't have to go in there and kill them, all the buildings sometimes. So here we're everything's repaired now, and so now we got no damage, and the guy didn't show up, so I'm just going to go ahead and take it. I was preparing it for him, but my chat is not working, and seem to show up and been waiting a while, so I don't want the time to expire. I'll just do another one for him, and I hope this was helpful. You know, here we are, fully cleared and no damage whatsoever. Not bad. Still have, I think, 8 minutes left on this base, and so it's effective, and this is really one of the harder ones. It took me a while to narrow it down to get no damage, but as always in my videos, that's what I attempt to do. So again, hope this was helpful. You guys have a good one out there. Merry Christmas. We'll see you next time.